usable space. The playground you can see there, that won Play Space of the Year for Australia in 2020, and it is awesome. You know, if you're an adult around about night time, all the kids go away, you can play in there too. It's great, they've got trampolines and swings, there's a BMX track through there, great. But the main reason for the upgrade is the green space we're about to see in front of us here. It makes a really, really good for market. And there's night market tonight that's going to be down here. Thursday night they hold market here, and also for the staircase to the moon. So tonight this road is going to be closed off. There's going to be food vans all on the whole thing. And there'll be a whole lot of market stalls in here, but the live music on the stage there. Definitely worthwhile checking out if you've got no plans. So the main reason they spent all this money and why they're building that big wharf there for people to stand on is for that staircase to the moon. Now, it's only happened during our full moon. It's about 3 weeks away before we get our next staircase. And a pretty good chance, more than likely, going to be cloudy. So we'll see how it goes. And that's going to see the big full moon rising up on the horizon there. It's going to be matched up with a big low tide, and that low tide is going to have that mud flat. And the moonlight is then going to reflect off the mud, giving you that beautiful staircase. Definitely something worthwhile to check out. So, you know, again, more reasons just to come back to Broome Tour. That'll do it. Just come down to the market tonight. It'll be a good time. Now, in front of us, we do have the museum as well. Now, this is the Broome Museum. It goes into a lot of that very colourful history that we have here in Broome. It's spread across three separate buildings that stuff doesn't fit in. And it's open every day from 10 till 1. And it costs about $12 if you're an adult. If you have my little concession card, drops it down to 8. And I believe if you're under 16, it is free. It's got a bunch of kids' activities and stuff here as well. Now, the segregation I mentioned earlier saw where people live being segregated as well. Town Beach here, this was all for the Europeans. Indigenous were all up on Kennedy Hill, and then the Asiatic people in Japantown, what we now call Chinatown. And off to our left, that is an original pearling master front, all built out of corrugated iron because it was cheap, it was light, and they could get it up on boats pretty easy. Now, that whole building is built with wind in mind. It's raised up off the ground, there's windows all around it, no air conditioning, so it's all about getting wind through. They still build homes out of corrugated iron to this day because they found as the wind blows over the iron, it actually helps to cool it down. We do get 10 months of wind here every year. Double brick homes, I can tell you from personal experience up here, are horrible. They hold all the heat, which means at 7 a.m. in the morning, at one time in a house I was in, it was 33 degrees in my room. This building off to our left though, this is a historically listed building. Used as a pearl shell grading shed, a store shed, a general store, all sorts of stuff. But past it here. They've got a restaurant in there as well. That's the best place in the public. It's probably got one of the best cocktail bars.
Oh,
in front of us, guys, is another historically listed set of buildings. These are the old boatyards. They used to repair boats here and actually build boats as well. The reason they were able to do that is the high tide comes up right now.
Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side.
We're on the mangroves kickoff.
I don't want to waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us. That love is all we'll ever trust.
Pretty high up on the ground.